Hey, Life Group leaders, Pastor Kyle here. Want to let you know a couple of things. The first is this is the last week of the Philippians series. Thank you guys for all of your help, for leading your groups, for being consistent, and God has brought so much growth. Remember that spiritual growth is oftentimes, it's not a microwave, it's a crock pot. And so we've deposited the seeds, we've planted, we've cultivated, we've watered, God will bring the growth. So stay patient, stay consistent. You guys have done an amazing job, and God is doing great things in the individuals, in the families, and in the groups that you lead. The next to let you know is that this coming Sunday, October 29th, we are going to be starting our Food Box program. This is a massive push for the church, huge impact in the community, so encourage the people in your groups to pick up a Food Box. Now, this week, we are going to finish up the book of Philippians in chapter 4, verses 10 through 23. Paul's going to be talking about the secret of contentment. It's a massively powerful, practical, and important passage where we look at what it means to be content. And whether we recognize it or not, we are often motivated by discontentment. If you think about almost every commercial, billboard, or advertisement is trying to sort of poke, is trying to prod, is trying to create a sense of discontentment. You need this, you have to have this. Who are you without this product? And so discontentment is something that as Christians, we have to make war on almost constantly. And it's something even outside the Christian faith. We see with the essentialist popularity, the minimalist movement going on. We see this growing understanding that we are deeply discontented as a society. And so what do we do about that? So as you're getting into your groups for your final week in the book of Philippians, think through a few of these things. The engaged questions, what's the funniest or most ridiculous TV commercial you've seen that's cultivated this sense of discontentment? Where are areas that you tend to find yourself being discontented? What provokes a sense of discontentment in your life? And then explore the passage. Couple of questions in that what Paul talks about finding learning the secret of contentment. Why does he use that terminology? Why is contentment so hard for the world to find? Philippians 4:13 is probably one of the most misused Bible verses in all of the scriptures. How would you explain it to someone in context? And then what is the fruit that Paul's mentioning in Philippians 4:17, this fruit that he sees growing to their credit? Then after you've worked through the scripture, you've thought about it, begin to apply it to your lives. Questions like, how would you define biblical contentment using this passage? What does it mean to be content as Paul outlines it? What are some of the results of a discontented life? How do I know? Oftentimes, we're not very self-aware. How do we know that we're deeply discontented and that our motives, our actions, and our words are showing a life of discontentment? What are some common areas of discontentment that we experience in our own hearts? What do you find to be the most helpful or challenging thing in the Philippians series? So this question kind of steps back from the contentment issue, and because this is the last week of Philippians, go ahead and ask your people, what has been the most helpful or challenging aspect of Philippians? What we want to do is, we don't want to just fly through this book and have finished and it's done, it's in the books, it's in history. Rather, what is the Holy Spirit uniquely ministering to your heart, your marriage, your family, and how can we as a group hold you accountable? How can you begin to and continue to apply what has been most helpful for you in this series? And then, as always, finish it off with prayer. Thank you guys so much for leading your groups, for many of you for starting a group during the 7 weeks. It's been a wonderful time. It's been awesome to see God working in many people's lives. And so we are just incredibly encouraged. And on behalf of the elders and the pastoral staff, thank you for serving the church and for serving your fellow believers during the Philippians series. So as always, we love you guys, and we will see you this Sunday for the final week of Philippians.